There is only abundance, no lack. If this wasn't clear already for you at this point, having learned about the origin story of infinity, creating free will and then creating all of creation, and the fact that everything happens all at once, and all that there ever exists is infinite, complete, parallel reality, and they're all accessible, they are all outside of time, they all timelessly, eternally exist. So all possibilities, all infinite possibilities, always simultaneously coexist and are accessible to your overall consciousness. If this itself is not enough to let you know that abundance is the very state of creation itself, that there is only abundance, that there is no lack, then this lesson hopefully will give you even more confirmation, even more angles to view existence from, that are in alignment with its natural law of abundance being all that there is. Again, I ask you to be reminded of the idea of parallel reality. But now look at the fact that this implies infinite abundance. If each moment is a snapshot, is a single configuration of the universe, and you can shift your consciousness through different types of configurations of complete universes, and every snapshot is its own complete, timeless, frozen moment. That means that everything that ever can exist, does exist, already exists, and is ever present and ever available, all contained within eternal now. The now of the I am consciousness itself, the now of the creator itself, this only moment that has ever experienced, now. All these realities, all possible realities that you or the free agent can ever conceive of already exist, and they always will be accessible. So, you see, there is only abundance, there is no lack possible, because lack would imply that something disappeared. But if each complete reality is its own snapshot of eternity, and it exists outside of time, outside of the illusion of time that we generate by moving from one image to the next, to the next, to the next, therefore creating the subjective experience inside of ourselves of time. But the frames that we have perceived at any given second are themselves not experiencing time. They are timelessly rested, eternally present and available. We generate the experience, the illusion of time by going from one complete timeless frame of existence to the next complete and timeless frame of existence, and so on. So you see, structurally speaking, time does not exist. This moment does not know time. This circumstance, this configuration of the universe does not experience itself in time. It does not experience itself as, oh, I am a snapshot that now appears out of nowhere and now disappears. We experience that things appear and disappear, but only because we move from left to right, so to speak. We move from this image to this image to this image. And as soon as we move to the next image, that means the previous image disappears from view, not from existence. There is a difference. And the free agent, or you, consciousness, you awareness, are effortlessly moving through millions of these every second. Millions of different configurations, different of complete, timeless reality. So, lack implies that something can actually disappear from being existent. We can generate the experience of moving on from one image to the next, and we do this all the time. Therefore, we can generate the experience of lacking something that we had before. But again, remember that within the overall consciousness, the thing you previously experienced and now choose to no longer perceive is still existent inside of your overall consciousness. But just know that consciousness has access to any potential possible configuration of creation. So nothing is ever lacking. Nothing is ever missing.
It's about 3 in the afternoon. Hottest part of the day, I reckon. Barely a cloud in the sky. I've just stopped in this field to take shelter under this beautiful old oak tree. So I'm 26k into an approximately 40k ride. I'm headed southeast from Avalon. There's no big towns on this route, there's only small towns, so I'm being pretty careful with my water, because obviously at the other end I need water to make food. And I'm headed for a large forest, which you can already see in the background. I mean, this whole hillside is just plantation forestry. It's literally just exactly the same species and age of pine, wall to wall. But where I'm going, by the high altitude imagery on Google at least, it looks like a bit more of a natural forest. And there's this huge lake, and I'm going to try and camp with a view of the lake if I can.
You see, in a timeless creation filled with infinite parallel realities that are each a complete universe in and of themselves, and that nothing that can ever be conceived of is ever not created, how could there be structural lack? There is no structural lack in existence. You are simply moving your consciousness from reality to reality, and sometimes you're not aware of certain things that you may desire to be aware of in that moment. Your vibratory attitude is not in alignment with that creation, therefore you cannot perceive of that coexisting within the same now, parallel reality that you otherwise could access if A, it was relevant for you to have that experience, and B, if you were of the appropriate vibrational attitude and perspective to be able to perceive that vibratory parallel reality within which the thing that you think is lacking now actually already does exist as a complete perfect reality. And again, using the power of imagination, you can tap into the vibrational experience of these things, even when they're not relevant for you to be physically inside of your personal consciousness view right now. But you can always have access to them on a non-physical level. And by doing so, you actually increase the probability that it becomes relevant for you to have these experiences pop into your view once again, or things that you have never created as a personal experience before can now pop into view, because you're moving your frequency along. What I want you to realize is that there is no lack in creation, that it is a fiction, that one of the fundamental principle or laws of creation is that there is only abundance and zero lack. And you can understand this, and you can start to free yourself and empower yourself. Rest yourself once again in that vibrational attitude of being the creator of infinity, of being an abundant, infinite vibrational consciousness, rather than a physical body or a physical mind. You are an overall consciousness that has the ability to generate an experience of whatever it wishes to tune into that already simultaneously exists with your present point of view.